Hey, I'm Jessica.
And I'm Mia.
And this is
Go Figure. And today we have Alters 1/6 scale, I guess, from one of my favorite games ever, Persona 3.
Oh yeah.
And this figure came out a while ago, like 2012. And I didn't know it existed, but then I saw it on AmiYami.
You didn't know it existed?
I didn't know. But I saw it pre-owned on AmiYami and I was like, oh. Okay.
You know, here at Go Figure, we're all about that base, huh?
Yeah. Okay, we're gonna talk about this.
Yes. Because it looks amazing.
I love this base. This is everything I want in a base.
Oh, it's so nice. It's very glossy and it's small.
It's small.
I'm so happy about that.
It's small, and you have the shadow like coming up to attacker. Like, it's so, like, this is perfect. This is what all bases should be. Once again, Alter, not disappointing me. God bless you. You're my favorite company. Okay, sorry. So this is Aya.
She's beautiful and very big.
A little heavy.
Oh yeah.
I'll be honest.
I wanna see.
Yeah, push it. She feels substantial. So to get her onto the base, she has this like little dent thing in her leg, and I'm pretty sure that just fits in right here.
And we think that's it, so...
And that's it!
We'll see.
So
try it, and then we'll see if there's anything else, but I don't think so.
It doesn't seem... it doesn't seem very safe.
Because this is, again guys, this is a big figure, it's kind of heavy, it's kind of scary.
Oh!
Woo! That just clipped in. Okay!
Oh look, we're holding hands!
Aww. Can I just say, when you showed it to me on AmiYami, I thought it was gonna be a beautiful figure, but I didn't think it was gonna ooze quality, kind of.
Yeah.
And I feel like it is nicer in person than I thought when I saw the pictures. It's really nice. I like it.
It's I never doubt Alter. Well, the thing that made me want to buy this is just her face. Like, seriously, like,
yeah.
So beautiful. Like, from a little bit of blush on her cheeks and her eyes. Like, it looks very realistic to me. Alter never disappoints me. Like, from the hair that is not transparent, but
it's a very interesting texture.
It's very interesting, like the way they've painted it here. Like, I can't really describe it. It's like shiny, but it's not transparent, but it almost makes you think it's transparent. It's just really, really nice.
And I really like the wires that are coming, kind of connecting her shoulders.
True, very
so
good
cool.
Detail. They've even gone out of their way to put her name engraved on her shoulder.
Yeah.
I think for their uniform during the daytime, they have a little ribbon, and Aya just keeps hers on. She's so cute.
Cause really cute.
She has to pretend to not be a robot when she goes to school.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Look at her little butt!
Yeah.
It's cute. I like that they bothered with those little creases here. It's funny. Probably one of Alter's like masterpieces.
Oh yeah. Oh my god, Mia. Now you're giving it the masterpiece.
Oh, I'm giving it. I'm giving it the masterpiece logo. It's happening. Mia approves. Like,
I think it's just because he just opened like 2 minutes ago.
No, but like what I mean is, I find it interesting that because sometimes when I look at older figures, I'm like, oh, okay, that's kind of an older figure. Like you can see that over time, the figure company has gotten better.
Yeah.
You know, and yet, like no, like I think if this figure were to be released today, I would hold it to the same standard as all the other new figures we open, you know?
That's true.
And I think that's worth, I think that's worth saying.
Is it 4 year old?
Almost 4.
Okay.
It's gonna be 4 years old next month.
What's it do with that base? Like, what's going
on? Well, the base is great because it's simple and yet it's a fully relevant to the video game.
So what's relevant to the video game?
Because basically in the game, like at nighttime, you go through the dungeon and the dungeon's floors are exactly this.
Okay.
You go through Tartarus, which is the dungeon, and when you're going through the dungeon, shadows come out of the ground and they attack you and then you're in battle. So this is an example of that.
Okay.
And it's just so dynamic.
So that's at night, right?
That's at night.
And so that's, she's at night in the dungeon and you can see that she's been battling because of
This is like her
leg.
Her battle appearance and
her
stuff.
Her leg is kind of torn.
That's true, yeah.
And then why is her foot open?
That's a good question. I actually don't know.
Is it because like there's some weapon coming out
maybe,
or something?
Maybe that's how she walks. I'm not really sure.
Okay.
That's a good question. I don't know. Just to say, I wish all bases were like this because they're simple, minimalist, but also 100% relevant.
So we've just changed places because we wanted to show you more in details the comparison in size.
Yep, so Jess got two of her Sonicals. So to the left we have her 1/5 Berry version, and on the other side is the 1/6 Rock and Roll. Two different companies, and yet, you know, different scale varieties as well. And right off the bat, I can see that the Aegis is kind of leaning more towards the size of the 1/5. I'm gonna give it 9.5 because
There's no weapon.
No.
She is the weapon, though.
So we guys, will
no
say
regrets. Bye. Have a robotastic day.
Oh. Bye, bye, guys.
Bye.